today we are going to discuss about the different energy transfer, heat energy transfer from one point to another. At the end of this lecture, you will be able to understand there are different way of energy transfer from one place to another. So let me start with a simple example. If I place a hot milk on the table, after some time this milk start to become cooling. So at the same time, if I place a bottle of a cold water on the table, what will happen? This cold water becomes start to warmer. So, but the situation is everything is same, but in both case one become hotter and other will become colder. The thing, my conclusion here at this point is that the heat energy is always transferring from one point to another, but it is always happening from hotter region to the colder region. At the case of milk, the hotter is milk, so from the milk to the surrounding heat is transferring. So in the second case is the cold water, in that case the surrounding is more hotter, so from the hotter region, that is from the surrounding to the water, is the heat transferring. So heat transferring through the different may happening in the different ways. The first one method is the conduction process. Conduction, this is the one method of heat transferring. The second one is the convection. The third one is the radiation. These are the three heat transferring methods. In the conduction process, the heat transferring from one point to another without the actual movement of the particle. In that case, the heat, when I heat up, the particle or the molecule start to vibrate about its mean position, it getting more kinetic energy. This energy is transferring from nearest particle to the second particle. So energy is transferring. The nearest particle also start to vibrate, and the energy is transferring from the particle to particle. In that case, there is no particle movement. But in the case of convection, the conduction process is more happening in the case of solids. But in the convection process, there is a heat transferring from one point to another with the movement of particle. This is happening mostly in the liquids and gases. That is the second one. The third one is the radiation. In the radiation process, heat transferring from one point to another, but there is no need of an intervening medium. There is no, even though there is no medium, the heat is transferring from one place to another. The heat energy is getting from the sun is the best example of the radiation. In the radiation, the heat is in the range of electromagnetic spectra, especially in the range, in the area of a infrared region. So that these are the three methods of heat transferring. So if I give an example of conductivity in the material, if I put a material, suppose this is a material of a shape cube, a cube shaped material, this is the one face of the cube and this is the second face. This at a separation at a separation at a x distance, this is heat is transferring through this material. Suppose this heat is transferring through this material, the first phase at a temperature theta 1 and second phase is temperature theta 2. The amount of heat transferring from through this material is, I put a, this is a Q, this is the amount of heat transferring is always proportional to the area of the cross section of the material. I denote as A as the area of cross section, and also it is proportional to the temperature difference. So theta 1 minus theta 2 as a temperature difference, and it is always proportional to the time of flow, how much time is the heat flowing. And one more factor is there, it is inversely proportional to the distance of the separation. So these 4 points, one is the area of cross section, temperature difference, time and distance, is the factors affecting the amount of heat flow. So this equation I can simply written as in a proportionality constant K, A into theta 1 minus theta 2 by X into T, where this Q, K is called, sorry, this K is called coefficient of thermal conductivity. this property, this coefficient is depend on the material. For different material, the coefficient of thermal conductivity is different. And this Q is equal to K when? This Q is equal to K when area of the cross section is equal to 1 centimeter square and the temperature gradient, theta 1 minus theta is the temperature difference at a, with a distance. So theta 1 minus theta 2 by x is, I can tell as a temperature gradient also. This temperature gradient d theta by dx support 1 degree Celsius per centimeter. And time is 1 second. In that time, this Q is equal to K. So, the amount of heat flowing through a material is when? When the material is 1 centimeter square area cross section, temperature gradient is 1 degree Celsius per centimeter and time of flow is 1 second, that much amount of heat is called coefficient of thermal conductivity of that material. So, in that way, thermal conductivity can be defined. So, some material is a good conductor, some are the poor conductors. So, depending on, so example, the metals are very good conductors of the heat and the wood or ebonite or some materials are the bad conductors. Depending on these properties we are using for different purpose. As an example, in kitchen utensils, kettle are the made up of the metal. But the body or the handle of the utensils, we are using wood. Why it's so? So, wood is a poor conductor and the material is a good conductors. And like in the winter region, in some countries during the winter region, the wall or the windows or the doors are the double door. Why is they using double doors? There are two phase. In between this double door, there is air. Is there air is a very bad conductor, so it's not conduct the heat. So in that way, there to using this property of the heat conductivity, we are using in different purpose. So, this is the definition of thermal conductivity of the material. So, the last point is, thing is that there is a famous law that is called Weidmann-Franz law. The what is Weidmann-Franz law? It's 1853. Weidmann and Franz done many experiments on the thermal conductivity and the electrical conductivity. The same like thermal conductivity, some materials are very good in the electrical conductivity. It will conduct electricity very much. So what they found that they had done the electrical conductivity and the studied the electrical conductivity and thermal conductivity of the metal. What they found that the ratio between thermal conductivity to the electrical conductivity of any metal is the same. It's the same so for a particular temperature. So the ratio of the K is the thermal conductivity and sigma is the electrical conductivity of a material is proportional to an absolute temperature. It's always depend on the same for all metal at a particular temperature. So, it's also denoted say, like K by sigma T is a constant. So, this is also a famous law regarding this electrical conduction. So, I concluding the point that what we have studied today is the heat energy transferring from one point to another. It's always happening from hotter region to the colder region. The second one thing is that there different way of heat transferring is happening. One is the heat conduction and second one is the heat convection and third one is the heat radiation. So, and also the Weidmann-Franz law. Weidmann-Franz law telling that the thermal ratio of thermal conductivity to the electrical conductivity for any metal of same for any temperature. So, this is all about today's lecture.